Look, my team don't play.
Switch locks.
What it look like? It's me and Doug.
And this is a Smoker's Review episode that we don't know because apparently we're potheads.
Yes, and this is the Black and Mild that we
are. Smoking in my grandma's house, obviously.
It's me talking about, but I told them not because it's rude.
Right under the picture of Jesus.
He's under. Oh, shit, I'm under.
I think you need to know what my grandmother is. Her team don't play.
There you go, this guy.
I'm trying to tell you, my granny got 7 wheelchairs outside.
She ain't playing?
She ain't playing. She ain't playing with you. Yo, it's good. Smoke's review. And today, we're going to do J. Cole's album.
And Gabe's album.
Alright, so starting off first, let's do Cole World, the sideline story. The highly anticipated debut of J. Cole. Which to me wasn't really highly anticipated. It just seemed like as soon as it dropped, a lot of y'all just started saying, "Hey, J. Cole's the greatest." So shout out to you. Shockingly. Yeah. Furthest thing from my mind, and I'm being as objective as possible. The nigga, he talks about a lot of shit that most rappers won't touch. I wouldn't necessarily put him in the Lupe Nas category yet, because I just don't think he's lyrically up to par with them. But as far as J. Cole, though, it was good. His singles are horrible. Trash. Remember Who That? Like, from last year?
Yeah, that I damn never
liked
that.
That shit damn sure made the album. And Who That was better than Workout. Way better than Workout. That shit is terrible.
Now, what was he thinking with that one?
Son, that shit is the worst. But yeah, his singles just wasn't up to par at all. But when you get into the album, the meat of the album, No Homo, it's actually pretty dope. Yeah, of course. What you thought about the album?
It was type cool. Like, I don't expect to sit there and listen to J. Cole. I'm not what everybody else listens to. Like, I listen to
what you like.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Album made me want to go download a couple of songs. And I ain't been gonna lie. It's like Tiger. Never listened to Tiger until I listened to that mixtape.
Yeah. Smoker's Review do be opening our eyes.
I ain't been going because of this nigga.
Smoker's Review definitely do.
I'm not listening to half of these songs. If I probably would have been saying anything about J. Cole. I don't even know who J. Cole is.
It's cool. Favorite song?
Favorite song? I'm about to go. Is that shit? Yeah, make sure I wrote it down so I have the names on point today.
Take this seriously. This is work.
It's a nice watch with Jay-Z. The Jay-Z bars was hard.
Did you like that song? I hated that song. And I really did think.
But I think it's because of Jay-Z.
I think Jay-Z really half-assed it. I like the way he came on, you know, with the Hugh Blow shit. That shit was hard.
That was hard.
But the rest of the shit, it kind of was iffy. And the song was just, it didn't, you could tell they wasn't in an album together. You could tell he sent that shit to Jay like a few months before. Jay just got around, was bored one day and said, I forgot about this, huh? We sent this to him, you know. It didn't seem like no vibe in that studio. My favorite song is Lost Ones. Because if you're a part of the money team like me, you know what I'm saying? And your
money
team
got a bunch
don't
of gay people
play,
in
you know, and your team don't play, I'm pretty sure you went through that situation, you know, where you asked that gold digger hoe to get rid of it. You know what I'm saying?
So, when you did all that, was your gay dudes that rape people with you?
They threw that bitch down the stairs.
They always on the phone that like niggas, and they gonna rape that nigga.
Oh, man, I didn't do it. It's the team, because the team don't play. Let's go to least favorite song.
Least favorite, I'm about to go with Never Told.
Never Told?
Yeah,
that makes sense. My least favorite song is actually, I'm going to go with, obviously, like I said, Workout. Workout was one of them. And Can't Get Enough. Like I told you, his singles just wasn't that good. His singles was trash. Trey Songz obviously didn't even need to be on it. One thing I don't like about it was that J. Cole did a lot of the singing. He's not Drake. He can't sing. He should have just got...
Since Drake did that, everybody trying to go
Yeah,
down that
that's
route.
Just bad PR by Roc Nation. If you want... This album was 3 months away from being a classic, honestly. 3 months away. If they would have held it and actually worked with him, developed him as an artist, he would have had a classic. Because the real part of the album, not the singles, is actually really good. If they would have got some R&B singers to sing it, has the type of vibe in the studio, and you would have had a classic guarantee. I guarantee that. Okay, so what you gonna give it? What's your rate?
If we have to give that haze,
I'm gonna give it dub. No, you can't
make that bet. So yeah, let's have to give it dub.
That's what I'm giving it. It wasn't even, it was actually, I downgraded it. Like, the first few times I listened to it, I was gonna give it the Kush, but I downgraded it a little bit because I just thought that, for somebody so lyrical, which opened my eyes to it, that it could have been way better. You understand what I'm saying? It should have been better. But I don't really even blame him. I just thought with all the pressure stuff, it's way better than Thank Me Later.
If Jay-Z wasn't thinking about making his own albums,
yeah, and passing the baton, passing the baton to Drake, you understand what I'm saying?
That is cold, that is signed with him.
You would have had a classic album. Red album, The Game. This is Game's, I think, fourth album. This is his fourth sus of the documentary. You know, his first album with G on it. But honestly,
he says he wrote
exactly. But this has been his best try at it, honestly, to me. What you thought about it?
So it's type cool. Like, I mean, same thing. With, I don't know. Like, I guess I just listen to the same rappers all the time. I mean, I heard a couple. I listen to Gabe freestyles. To me, his freestyles be better to me. I don't know.
Than the songs.
Yeah. But this shit was good, too.
Yeah. As far as this, I think Game has proven himself to be, big statement, the most versatile rapper out right now. You listen to any song on that album, he switched his flow. Like, my city, straight West.
Hey, that's great because that's my favorite song, too.
Yeah, exactly. Like, he's straight West Coast in it. But then you listen to Speakers Bumping. He adopted, because he was on a song with Big Boy. He took Andre 3000's flow. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it go on and on like that.
He don't get that attention.
He don't get that. It's exactly. You know, but it's,
after that whole 50 day.
Yeah. But versatility, lyrics. He has all. I mean, a lot of it. It's just, I think what I needed was it to be like a little bit more linear, like a little bit more in order. But the songs, I can't complain about the songs at all. It's just good music. It seemed like he worked with whoever he wanted to work with.
Yeah.
It's just a really, it's a well put together album.
So he should have did after that whole 50 Cent.
It's gonna, yeah, exactly. It's gonna be go over a lot of people's heads this year. But it's might be kinda, it's top 10, not top 5 best rap albums so far this year. You know what I'm saying? So, what's your favorite song?
Favorite song.
What's your favorite song?
Favorite song, My City.
Mm-hmm. People, that's Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah,
Kendrick Lamar definitely went off on that. I definitely can't stop.
My fault, The City. See, the that's city. Why I wrote the names down, because I always mix it up. Yeah. The City.
I think it's a lot of songs on this album. It's all really a lot of songs. So I have two favorite songs.
I got two, but that in.
Heavy Artillery. Heavy Artillery with Ross and Beans. Yeah, I really do like Beans. I like Beans verse a lot. I really do. Yeah, I definitely do like Beans. Least favorite song?
Least favorite song is the Red Nation. Sorry. It's old. I don't know why you put it on the album. I didn't like the song from the before.
Go with, you should have came clear, like Paramedics featuring Jeezy. You like that song? That's my least favorite. All right, what's your rating?
Right here? Mm-hmm. I'm going to have to go with the same haze dub bag.
Are you really? Yeah. I'm going to see your haze. I'm going to up you a Kush. We'll go ahead and give that Dom back a Kush.
I don't know. I couldn't give it the Kush.
Couldn't give it the Kush?
I had to give it the dub bag.
I had to give it the dub bag. I'm going to give it the Kush, you know? I have to give it the haze dub bag. All right, man. So there it goes. That's the second one. Once again, sending your mixtapes to @yourorangenation@gmail.com or @warrenG693@gmail.com. And it looks like we'll be packing it in for the winter. We'll be under the Jesus poster more often. Supposedly. And remember, when all else fails, remember, your team doesn't play. You are part of the money team. If you're watching this, you are part of the money team.
Yo,
and your team don't play.
I'm with the money team right now. And I'm tired of being humble with niggas.